I work for an organization called CABI. We are a global organization and specialize in knowledge and information on agriculture and the environment. And because climate change is affecting the countries that we work in, it's very important to be here and to see what is being decided at a global level. And of course, my hope is that we will not just have talks here, but that afterwards there will be actual action on the ground, because that's highly necessary.
Well, today is Farmers' Day. What's being said? And
well, this morning there was a panel with farmers who said climate change is all over the place. We are affected by pests and diseases that are moving in that we've never seen before. Rainfall patterns are changing. It's drier now in Kenya, wetter now in South America. So farmers can no longer rely on the traditional methods that they used to use to understand when the rainy season would start, when they would be sowing, etc. So they are absolutely affected, and that is urgent. We need to do something about that.
Is that getting across the negotiators who are drafting this grand Paris Agreement?
I'm not so sure. I haven't seen the Paris Agreement. I haven't seen the negotiations yet. Today's my first day here, so.
But we've seen a bunch of so-called INDCs, countries' climate plans, over the last few months, which have been talking about making economies more resilient to climate change and talking about how much they're going to put towards adaptation measures and the rest. So is part of the battle being won?
In terms of agriculture, it is rather difficult to differentiate adaptation from mitigation, and I think it's more about resilience, making sure that farmers understand what crop to grow so they have yield at the end of the day, they have a market at the end of the day, and they know what to expect in terms of what practices they need to put in place to have a good return on investment. I don't hear that much about that. I think the world's doing a lot of very good research. The issue is, how do we get the knowledge in the hand of the smallholder farmers who need it to have a profitable agriculture?
Do you have any examples of successful pilots in countries you've been based in you'd like to discuss?
Yes, we have a program called PlantWise, and that is where we mimic the human health system for plant health. So instead of general practitioners, we have plant doctors. So extension staff are being trained to do good diagnosis and to provide good recommendations to farmers. And that is really helping to reach out to those in the field who never have that kind of information. So that also helps us track where are the pests and diseases of today. That program is now active in 34 countries. We will be in 40 countries in a couple of years' time. And we are seeing that pests and diseases are moving. And so we can use information developed in one country to help farmers in another country. And I think that is an example of a pilot that could be scaled out and have a good impact on millions of farmers. We're already reaching out to a lot of them.
Thanks very much.